Hi all, dear students, today we are going to see lesson number 16 and 17, that is representing information, defining a code. So, what is meant by code? Code is a particular something secret message or something secret. So, let us see in detail. You know mathematical symbols very well. So, that is plus sign, minus, that is subtraction, multiplication, division or equal to. These are codes only. These symbols are nothing but a codes for particular word. Plus sign is used to add two different values. You know it very well. Minus sign, that is single dash, is used to subtract value. If you will see cross sign, then that time you will always multiply one value by another. And particularly division symbol. So, its meaning is not changing. Whenever you see particular symbol, you are always doing the same operation as it is defined. So, these are the specific codes or you can say specific symbol for mathematical operation. And it does not change also. So, code is a special symbol or figure or number or letter, and it can be used to communicate a secret meaning. We can define our own set of codes, and computer can understand special code for different instruction. So like this, if we are writing a specific date, let us say 29th of January 2021. So, if this is the format or this is the value, then you can come to know, yes, this is the date. Now, you know it very well that algorithm is a list of steps, or you can say an algorithm is a set of instructions which you have to follow to do a task. And program is what? Program is an algorithm that has been coded into something that can be run by a machine. It means whatever the instructions we are writing in algorithm, that we have to convert in the form of code which computer can understand. Then that is nothing but a program. So, we can convert a particular algorithm in the form of code. Let us see. As you can see in the picture, in this square, a particular boxes are colored with green color. So, if we want this task, we want to finish this task, then we can write the instructions or we can code a particular program. So, we have to start from the box where start is given, and one by one we have to write the instructions. So, as you can see in the picture, we want a particular second column first row, that box as a colored box in green color, and second row third column, it should be in green color. And to get that output, we have to write the instruction, we have to write the code. So, that instruction can be, see, we will start from the start box. Move one square right. Fill the square with green color. Move one square right. Move one square down. Fill the square with green color. It means to color these two boxes, we have to write five instructions. Okay. So, we can code these instructions. Whatever the instructions we have written now, that is move one square right. So, we can assign a specific code to this instruction. Let us see that. Suppose this right arrow you can use to move one square right. Sorry. Left arrow you can use to move one square left. Up arrow you can use to move one square up, whereas down arrow you can use to move one square down. And C you can use to fill the square with green color. That is, green C can be used to fill the square with green color. So whatever the instructions we have written just now, we can code like this. See, you can see in the picture, that is, move one square right, that is right arrow, fill the square with green color, C. Move one square right, right arrow, move one square down, down arrow, and fill the square with green color so that we can get the specific objective. So like this, we can assign, what we have done here, we have assigned a code. This is coded language. So we have created program. This is nothing but a program. So for particular, to color a particular box in the given grid, we have to write the instruction accordingly. Thank you.